What's up, guys? Antoine here from Culture Matters. Hey, I hope everyone's having an awesome, awesome day. And I just wanted to take a stop for a moment and just talk to you about the importance of education. Okay? Education. And now, I'm not talking about education in the traditional sense of, hey, you need to go to school type of mentality. I'm talking about education finding the answer within. Okay? Find the answer within. Have you ever remembered any stories growing up of how maybe your mom told you, oh, I wish you would just listen for a moment, okay? Because number one, I told you where that certain thing was at, and you're always moving too fast before you stop and listen to any directions. Maybe you've heard this before, maybe you haven't. However, I've heard this all the time growing up. So what that meant for me was that if I'm not gonna slow down, okay, and if I'm not gonna pay attention to what someone else is telling me, if I don't particularly agree with what someone else is telling me, because I had an authority problem growing up, like I didn't like people telling me what to do, you know, like in school, teachers telling me this and that and grading me and judging you on the work and how smart you are, I didn't like that. I didn't like that whole process. However, what it taught me was, by being so rebellious, find the answer within. And this is actually educate, which is the root word of education, means finding the answer within. So, funny enough, you know, that's how I learned, because I needed to learn for myself. I had to find the answer within. Someone could have told me the hole was there, I would have stopped in the hole a couple times and I would have figured out why the hole was there, what it was doing there, how it got there, and how I need to avoid it next time. So I found the answer within, but if I had been smart enough, I would have listened to the person that said, hey, there's a hole right there, and then I wouldn't have fell in the hole. I would have stood on the shoulders of the people that came before me, and I would have learned from their experience. And that's the whole takeaway from life, okay? You want to learn from others and take that data and then internalize that data and understand the pros and the cons of what you learned and how to apply that in your life and find the answer within. Because we cannot refine what we do not define, okay? So we can't define what, we cannot refine what we do not define. So to give you an example of finding the answer within and like self-education, okay, if you are into a particular topic and you like certain things and you have certain hobbies, well, you're gonna look into those things, right? Well, if there's something that you don't know about, you need to look into those things and you need to learn about them. So finding the answer within in a real life application is, hey, my sink broke. I don't have enough money to pay for a plumber. Well, you know what? You better find the answer within and find information and data to help you solve and achieve your problem, internalize it, make it your own, learn it, and fix your problem. Maybe you have to take a couple lines out and switch the lines out. Now, if you're not a handy person, then you're going to have to find the answer within. Because education is all about learning the things that you don't know. And maybe sometimes things that you don't want to learn, but will help you in your life. So if learning certain things and certain tasks doesn't excite you, that's okay. However, if it's gonna help you and it's gonna push you further, you're doing yourself a disservice by not having an interest in those things and pursuing and taking an action to go and to learn about them. So, we cannot refine what we did not define. So, another aspect to look at it is in a philosophical aspect. If you're trying to figure out like what certain things mean to you, like me, you know, one day I was sitting there, I'm like, what does love really mean to me? Like, I know how it feels. There's all different kinds of love. And I was pondering about love. And so I said, okay, you know what? And I broke this down and I said, love to me, if I'm gonna define it so that I can refine it, love, longing, of value every day. So how do I define love? Love to me is something that I'm gonna long for because it has value to me. And if I don't have it, every day I go without it, I'm going to be longing for it. And that's my circle of love. Now, you can put love into a context of your own and make it mean something to you. And you can do this with any word, with any symbolism or analogy that you like to use. Okay? So, when we're looking for things, let's say our topic is love. Okay? We're gonna wanna find, what is it? Define it. Refine it by making it mean something to you. Whatever the topic is, what is it? And define that topic. Refine it by making it mean something else to you, by making it mean something to you. So, education is finding the answer within. Personal development is based on this ideology. If you're looking to better yourself and improve your mental well-being, then you're going to need to educate yourself with all of the information in the world that is available to you through computer technology, okay? Now more than ever, we have more information about humanity and about our world and about the things that happen than ever before in any other history of age. So take advantage of it, make it work for you and better yourself by finding the answer within and solving your problems to your life from within by bettering yourself and by bringing you on a higher consciousness level. So guys, I hope you got some great value. I love yous all. Have an awesome day. Check us out, www.culturemattersuniversity.com. See you soon.